Friends, we will go to the next topic on basic invoice verification. So in my previous video, we had done one exercise on how to post invoice for a simple account assignment and the invoices for purchase orders with account assignment. Now we will go to the next part, which is section C, where we will learn how to post invoices with multiple account assignment. So let me go to the data sheet here. I will go to data sheet here. Section C. So this is the data we have. You have received the following partial invoice for 50 office files from the vendor. The PO is for 100 office files which have already been delivered. The invoice amount should be distributed proportionately between the cost centers. Post the invoice in logistic invoice verification. See here, vendor has given invoice for only 50 office files, but the PO is for 100 files which have already been delivered. That means we have received only partial invoice for 50 pieces from the vendor. Okay, so enter the basic data and allocate the invoice. The files have been procured for cost centers. Select a suitable layout and allocate the invoice for the purchase order. Okay, the transaction code to post invoice is MIRO. I will go to SAP and let me go to the MIRO screen. Put MIRO, enter. Input today's date. Then he has given for 50 pieces, right? 50 pieces. So let me even go to the data sheet here. So this is the reference number, last 5 digit of the PO 179.35. Then amount is 550 rupees, tax amount is 50 rupees, and the PO number is 179.35. Okay, so let me go to the PO number 179.35. So here the total quantity is 100 office files. Okay, and if I go to the purchase order history, so already all the 100 pieces have been received. GR is already posted for all the full quantity. If you go to the account assignment tab here, so all the 100 pieces have been divided among 3 cost centers. Okay, out of the 100, 40 pieces have been allocated to cost center 1111, another 40 pieces to cost center 1112, and 20 pieces to cost center 1220. Okay, now what we will do, we will go to the invoice, and also we have to input the proper tax code. So the tax code here in invoice is S2. So here we will go to the, after input today's date, we have received only how much? 50 pieces, right? The total 1 is 10. 10 into 100 is 1000 rupees. Okay, invoice is only for 50. 50 means 50 into 10, 500. 500 and 10% tax. Okay, I will show the tax amount also. S2, it is 10% tax, input tax. Okay, 10% input tax. So 10% of 500 is 50 rupees will be the tax amount. And 500 rupees will be material cost, and the amount we have to pay in invoice is 550. Okay, 550, and tax amount is 50, and the tax code I had to change it to S2 here as per the purchase order. Okay, go to PO reference, input the PO number 4500179.35. Enter. Okay, as soon as you put the PO number and press enter, system has suggested total amount is 1000 rupees and quantity is 100. Okay, but we have received invoice only for partial quantity, which is 50. So this is showing balance also. So now what we need to do, I will go to, now I have to change the, total amount and total quantity here. Okay, what I need to do, I will go to edit here. Since we have procured for 3 different cost centers, out of the 100, system has as per the purchase order, 40 pieces for cost center 1111, 40 pieces for cost center 1112, and 20 pieces for cost center 1220. And the amount is 40 into 10, 400 for cost center 1111, 400 rupees for cost center 1112, and 200 rupees for cost center 1220. But now, since the invoice is vendor has given invoice only for partial quantity of 50 pieces, I am going to change the quantity here. 50 and amount is 500. Okay, now what I will do, I will press check. As soon as I click the check button here, system will change the quantity here. Okay, into half, 40 it will change it to 20, this 40 it will change to 20, this 20 it will change it to 10. Okay, 20 plus 20 plus 10, it will be 50. Okay, system will distribute the amount also. Here 400 it will change to 200, with 200, 100. 200 plus 200 plus 100 is 500. Okay, so now it will change the quantity and also amount. Okay, Now what I will do, after I input the total quantity 550 and total amount 500, I will click the check button. See, now it has changed the quantity from 40 to 20 and the amount from 400 to 200. Same here also, 40 to 20 amount from 400 to 200, and here the quantity from 20 to 10 and the amount 200 to 100. Okay, now click back. Okay, now it has changed the total, that is the quantity and also amount for the different cost centers. As per the total amount and total quantity, we have entered in the multiple account assignment window. Now I will click simulate. Yeah, now we can see here, this is the total amount we are going to pay to the vendor, 550, and 200 for that is this 200 is updated for the cost center 1111, 200 rupees for cost center 1112, 100 rupees for cost center 1220, and 50 rupees for the tax, input tax, tax account. These are the GL accounts postings. Click back. Okay, now click post. System will post the invoice and the same invoice number will be updated in the purchase order history. Once the invoice is posted, we will go to the PO and check the purchase order history and see the invoice number. Yeah, invoice is posted and the invoice document number is 51056095. So now I will go to the PO number here in the PO history. Before posting invoice, only GR. Now I will click display change. Again click display change and go to item detail and PO history. Now we can see the invoice is posted. This is the invoice document number. So 20 pieces and 200 rupees for one cost center. 20 pieces, 200 rupees for another cost center, 10 pieces and 100 rupees for another cost center. Okay, this is only partial invoice. If I click here, this will go to the display invoice and I can display the accounting document by clicking here, following documents. Yeah, this is the accounting document. Double click on the accounting document. So these are the account postings. Okay, 550 rupees for the vendor account, 200 rupees for consumption. Okay, consumption to cost center 1111, 200 rupees and cost center 1112, 100 rupees to cost center 1220, 50 rupees. This is the input tax account, input tax GL account back. Okay, so this is how to post invoice for a multiple account assignment for a purchase order, and that to a how to post partial invoice for a multiple account assignment. Thank you for watching my video. Please give me your valuable comments, likes, and please subscribe to my channel so that you will get notification of my upcoming videos on several scenarios on MM. Thank you.